Hey, this is Luke Simons with Salt Strong. In this video, we're gonna be covering fishing reels, and more importantly, just the different type of fishing reels. So if you're new to fishing, you can get just a nice overview of what types of reels are out there and in what situations you would use one versus the other, pros and cons, that sort of thing. So let's go ahead and get started. First of all, this is I'll call this a push button type of reel. And this, as you can see here, it's a frozen. In case you can't see it, this is a frozen rod reel. This is the most basic of all reels, because literally all it involves is just one button. You push the button, line goes out, and then as soon as the cast is done to retrieve line, you just start turning the reel, and that line is reeling in. So this type of reel is best for just young kids. Just very easy, very few moving parts, very little to break. Literally just push the button, line goes out, turn the handle, line comes in. And then there's a little drag feature. Most of the drags are on the side for these. And the drag is what, of course, measures the tension required before the line gets let out. So anyhow, this is the push button reel. Very easy to use, very inexpensive in most cases. This entire combo was maybe like $10. So for a really young kid out there, this would be the way to go. All right, so next is a spinning reel. This is probably the type of reel that can be used in the most situations. It's probably the most popular because of that. And you can see it's very different than the push button reel that we just looked at. So this type of reel relies on a bale to control the line. And literally just flip the bale open, the line comes out, flip the bale back, and then start reeling in, and the line comes back in. And again, this is a type of reel that's a little bit more complicated than the push button. So for really young kids, this might be a little bit too advanced. But for kids in maybe the 7 years old or more, this would be a way to go. And as far as there's really no age maximum for these. These are, again, very good reels that can be used in so many different situations. I personally use these probably 99% of the time, because again, they're just super effective. And obviously there's a lot of different price points on these. This one here is a very cheap one that we bought for this kids course that we're making. This whole combo, this reel and rod, was under $20, and it also came with some lures. So there's a ton of options out there. If you are new to fishing and getting a young child out fishing, I would recommend just getting a cheap one and just making sure they like it, understand how to use it, and are comfortable with it, and then maybe upgrading later. And for tips on exactly how to use this, just click the link below, and I'll walk you through exactly how it works, how to set your drag, how to cast, how to retrieve, and that way you know exactly how this works before you make your purchase. All right, so the third type of reel, this is what's called a bait caster. This one is very different than the others. It's almost looks like a push button. It does have a little button to push. In most cases, sometimes it's up on the side. This one is right down here in the bottom. But you can see here the line. This is the spool of line. It's exposed. And this is probably the most advanced reel out there as far as the conventional reels. Because how it works is you push the button and this spool is unlocked. And so when you make your cast, you have to actually keep your thumb on the spool throughout the entire cast and apply the right pressure at the right time for it not to go too far, which creates what's called a bird's nest. So this is the most difficult reel to use. If you're, again, for the course that this is being designed for, I recommend not getting these, because these are, again, more difficult. These are not for beginners. For beginners, I would stick with the push button that we did first or the spinning reel. So hold off on this one for now. If you are interested in exactly how to work it and how to use it, I'll be happy to make a video. But for the purpose of this course, which is tailored to getting kids out in the water, catching fish in the most easiest way possible, we are going to skip over this one. I just wanted to let you know what it looked like and what the purpose of it was. So for details on how to use the push button reel or the spinning reel, you can just scroll down below and you'll see links to those videos. And we're going to cover the mechanics of it, exactly how they work, how to let line out, how to cast, of course, how to retrieve line, and how to set the drag. Just all the things you'll need to know to get out there and use these reels effectively. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment down below. Otherwise, see you on the next video.